Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. I think today we've got a rather interesting video in store, and this has to do with Netflix dropping a trailer today for a new adaptation of a novel, Uglies. This particular film will star Joey King. I think this adaptation is interesting because it really shows that Netflix is trying to take that dive into these teenage book adaptations. This particular film is based on the first book in a franchise that spans now over 8 books in total from 2005 to 2022. So there's a lot of room to grow, a lot of room to kind of build from this movie and hopefully into the future. You know, when you look at a property like this, it's very much stacks up with something like The Hunger Games or Insurgent or even The Maze Runner. I think it is very much within that kind of vein of those films and of those franchises and what they were trying to do, which makes a lot of sense. Again, those were teen dramas as well. But to pick a particular series that ranges 8 books in total, I think is very ambitious and says a lot about where they think this franchise can go moving forward. Joey King in that lead role is a good pickup for them as well. Somebody who has very much had success on the platform. When you look at her trilogy with The Kissing Booth in particular, I think being able to put her in that star role and again, kind of having that volume behind her, having that success on the platform already, really shows what Netflix thinks of her and where she could take this moving forward. I will admit this isn't a franchise I'm all that familiar with. I pulled it up this morning and brought it to the attention of my wife. She told me that it was one that really stood out to her growing up, one that she was familiar with, one that was very popular as well, which makes a lot of sense. I think if something is going to go 8 books, I think that really kind of speaks to the popularity of that particular franchise and those characters and that world. You know, I don't know if it's fair to compare this to something like Hunger Games or Insurgent or even Ender's Game, for instance, but again, clearly Netflix has a lot of hope and a lot of ambition picking up a particular book like this, and it's very clear to see that they are expecting it to do well and be able to build this franchise out moving forward. I think the last time I sat down to watch something like this, you know, it really has been a minute. It might have been something like Maze Runner or Insurgent, which is a shame. That's a franchise that ultimately we didn't even get to see kind of find its conclusion. You know, if you're going to pick up something that's got 8 books and that much material behind it, something to work off of, you know, I hope that at the bare minimum, they're able to get through those first 4, I guess, which is kind of a self-contained story. And get halfway through or to get one film in really is disheartening to fans of these books, even regardless of how, you know, good the adaptation might be. So interested to see how this trailer stacks up, what they're trying to go for, and just how big Joey King is in this. But before we get to the trailer, if you'd be so kind to smash that like button, hey, go ahead and hit that subscribe button for me as well. I want to let you know that over the weekend, we will be taking a look at Inside the Mind of a Dog, a new Netflix documentary that came out today. It's one that I think is very pertinent to me, being a dog owner myself. I'm interested to see just what they have to say about how intelligent dogs actually are. Well, I find it interesting that my dog, I swear, is smarter than she lets on. I mean, it's a little frustrating from time to time, so maybe I'll be able to learn a trick or two in there.
Tally, time to wake up.
All my life, I wanted to be pretty. I thought it would change everything. I hope that's still true.
For those of you turning 16 today, you've waited your entire lives for this moment. All the flaws you have today will be gone tomorrow. With one elegant procedure, you'll be beautiful. Because everyone is accepted, no one is left behind.
Will you promise me something? No matter how pretty they make you, just don't let them erase you.
Promise.
You get the surgery, they tell you what to do, and that's it. Paris?
What are you doing here?
I was worried.
Things are just different, yeah? You'll get it when you're pretty.
There's something about this place. It's not what it seems. What if I told you that there's an alternative? I know this place.
Welcome to the smoke.
They have a different way of doing things.
And we will do whatever it takes to protect that.
you want to learn how to fly, you got to learn how to fall.
These people want to end us.
The smoke has decided their way of living is more worthy than ours.
I was told these lies my whole life. It's time for you to make a choice. All my life, I wanted to be pretty. I thought it would change everything.
I don't really know how to feel about that. It looks like a movie that is going for something meant to be kind of vain with beautiful people, which is weird when the title is The Uglies. I'm very confused by some of the elements at play there and kind of just generally speaking from what the trailer shows. I will say it looks like a huge box office film, something that could very well translate to the big screen and hit that, get a theatrical release and find an audience there. So I think for Netflix to take a chance on something like this, and again, looks like put quite a bit of money behind it, really speaks again to what they are hoping this film can do and potentially where this franchise can go. But let me know though, for anyone out there who's read these books or even just this first one, do I need to read this book before sitting down and watching this in early September? Would that be helpful? Kind of getting the vibe that that might be the case. So just let me know in the comments for sure. But until next time, have a great time curling up on the couch and enjoying a good show.